Before we get into today's video, I would like to give a shout out to one of our newest subscribers, Lucas Pelletier. If I didn't shout out your username, it is because I did not receive any notifications that you joined. However, I thank all of you who have joined the channel in the recent weeks. And I welcome you to our little family. And thank you for becoming a downloader. Now, without further ado, let's get into today's video. Greetings, my dear viewers. It is I, Drayhan, and welcome back to Dungeons & Dragons Character Conversion, where we take a look at some of fiction's greatest characters and convert them into a playable character for Dungeons & Dragons 5th Edition. And today we are looking at one such great character, Virgil Hawkins, from Static Shock. Whether you have read the comics or have seen the TV show, or even the most recent Young Justice, you probably know Virgil and his alter ego, Static. And the old TV show was something that I grew up with. Something that I enjoyed immensely. And that old TV show, I would recommend to any parent who is looking for child-friendly entertainment. It has superheroes who, more often than not, will try to find a non-violent approach when it's necessary. Static will usually just cause harm to distract. He'll throw objects with his powers, or he'll do the occasional zapping, but he won't cause too much harm. It's more of a diversion tactic, a way to exhaust his enemies. We actually see this in a couple of different episodes, but one episode where he doesn't choose violence is when he is trying to help a super villain that is in sort of a rehab situation, Rubber Band Man. And, well, it actually works. I mean, sure, Rubber Band Man does get into some tight situations, but Static still is there to help him. But that's not the only thing. You have life lessons. Loss of a loved one. Bullying. Ethnic discrimination. Take your pick. They have dealt with it. In fact, speaking of ethnic discrimination, the best episode, in my opinion, has to be Sons of the Fathers. Because it goes deep into ethnic discrimination, what most people call racism. I say ethnic discrimination because it is the correct terminology. So, anyway, I could get into a whole rant, but we're not going to. Let's go ahead and get into the character build for today. Starting off with the point buy system, we have Strength and Constitution at a 10, Dexterity and Intelligence at a 13, Wisdom at a 12, and Charisma at a 15. Static got his powers from an incident known as the Big Bang. Static just happened to be at the wrong place at the wrong time when the authorities used tear gas on a gang fight, causing experimental chemicals to explode. Now, this chemical explosion gave most of the members in that zone powers. And they were later classified as Bang Babies. Very strange terminology. But anyway, that's how Virgil got his powers and became Static Shock. Variant Human gives us the ability score improvement to 2 stats. 1 to Intelligence and 1 to Charisma. We'll get a skill in Insight, and we get the feat Elemental Adept. We're going to go with the Lightning Damage. So this will increase our damage output. Moving on to our background, since he is a superhero, we're going with the Faceless background. This will give us proficiencies in the skills Deception and Intimidation, as well as the Disguise Kit. We'll get 1 language of choice, and we have 2 features, the Faceless Persona and Dual Personalities. Though Static really doesn't change his personality, he's still Virgil, still acts like it. Moving on to our class, we're going with Sorcerer, since that is the closest thing to powers that you gain from an event. You get a 1d6 hit die, you get some extra hit points of 1d6 plus your constitution modifier per sorcerer level. The proficiencies are daggers, darts, slings, quarterstaffs, light crossbows. Saving throws in constitution and charisma, and 2 skills, arcana and persuasion. You also get a spellcasting ability using your charisma modifier. And for your sorceress origin, the closest I can get to is Storm Sorcery. This gives us the abilities Windspeaker and Tempestuous Magic. This gives us a bonus to lightning and thunder damage, as well as being able to cause some extra abilities when spells of those nature are used. We're going to multi-class into Artificer, because while I was looking for some particular images for this video, I found this comic panel with Virgil working at Star Labs and working on this mechanical raptor. I thought it would be a good idea to reference this panel in this build, so I went ahead and went with Artificer, even though in the cartoon that was primarily the role of his best friend Richie. This will give us a d8 hit die, some extra hit points with a d8 hit die plus our constitution modifier per Artificer level, extra proficiencies in light armor, medium armor, shields, firearms, thieves tools, and tinker's tools. Now, one thing about firearms is that Virgil is against them, simply for the fact that, well, that's how his mother died. Gunshot. If I remember correctly, it was from a gang. So that's another reason why Virgil would not support any gang activity, including a particular gang in today's society. But I'm not going to rant about that, because this is probably my 6th take already, and I have done nothing but rant on and on about how much I do not like this group. So, yeah. Let's go ahead and continue. You get another spellcasting ability using your intelligence modifier, and you also get magical tinkering. Level 2 sorcerers get Fount of Magic. Level 3 sorcerers get metamagic options. I would suggest going with Transmuted Spell and Quicken Spell. There are going to be a couple of spells at the end of this video that do not use lightning or thunder damage, so we're going to be using Transmuted Spell to change those spells into lightning or thunder damage. Level 4 sorcerers get an ability score improvement. Go ahead and increase your dexterity and your intelligence each by 1. Level 6 sorcerers get Heart of the Storm and Storm Guide from their Storm Sorcery origin. Level 2 Artifices get Infuse item. Once again, I would recommend referencing the Velociraptor mech in the panel that we mentioned previously. So probably grabbing a homunculus or something. But in all honesty, just having any infusion that assists static will be preferable. Level 8 Sorcerers gets an ability score improvement. Go ahead and increase your charisma by 2. Artificer level 3 will get an Artificer Specialist. Go with the Battlesmith. This will give us a mechanical robot sidekick like that Velociraptor mech that we mentioned. And we also get some additional spells in Heroism and Shield. Tool proficiencies in Smith's Tools. We get the Battle Ready feature as well. Some very decent abilities. Though this class isn't entirely necessary for static, I thought it was just a good idea to reference some of the comic features. Level 10 Sorcerers get more metamagic options. We'll go ahead and grab the Heightened Spell metamagic option, just to make it a little bit trickier for your foes to save against some of your more powerful spells. Level 4 Artificers get an ability score improvement. Go ahead and increase your intelligence by 2. Level 12 Sorcerers also get an ability score improvement. Go ahead and increase your charisma by 2, maxing it out at 20. Level 14 Sorcerers get Storm's Fury as part of their Storm Sorcery origin. And finally, at level 16, we would get an ability score improvement for our sorcerer, but instead we're going with the feat Elemental Adept and grabbing Thunder Damage. Now, while that is the end of the build, it is not the end of the video, as we do have some spells to cover. So, for our Artificer spells, we have Guidance and Message for cantrips, and Featherfall, Identify, and Snare for our first level spells. For our Sorcerer spells, we have the cantrips Dancing Lights, Mending, Lightning Lure, Mage Hand, Shocking Grasp, and Thunderclap. For our first level spells, I would recommend Catapult, Magic Missile, Shield, and Witch Bolt. Catapult because, well, like I said, he will use his powers to fling objects at some targets just to cause a distraction. Whether that be a sewer grate, a set of keys, maybe even a fire hydrant. We'll use what he can to distract, have the attention pulled to him, to try to cause less damage. Second level spells, we have Hold Person, Knock, and Shatter. Third level spells, we have Fly and Lightning Bolt. Fourth level spell, we have Storm Sphere. Fifth level, we have Hold Person. Sixth level, Chain Lightning. Seventh level, we have Firestorm. And that's the spell we're going to be using our metamagic option of Transmute spell on to have either a Thunderstorm or a Lightning Storm. And for our 8th level spell, we have Power Word Stun. And that is the end for today's video. I do hope that you enjoyed. If you would like to see a particular character in the Dungeons & Dragons style, let me know in the comment section down below. Until next time, this has been Drahan, and I am offline.